from the first of these experiments in which we allow the cart to accelerate on a level plane under different numbers of washers, under the influence of gravity and different numbers of washers, so we have a cart washer system being accelerated by gravity in this direction, which of course pulls the cart around in this direction. We're going to get a straight line for acceleration versus number of washers. The slope of this graph is going to tell us the number of centimeters per second squared of acceleration change, that's a delta acceleration, per washer. So we're going to find out how many centimeters per second squared the acceleration changes per added washer. And the situation depicted in the small picture here, we have an inclined ramp, and we're going to think of adding washers and adjusting the incline until the cart moves up the incline at a constant speed under, again, the force of the washers. The slope of this ramp, or of this graph, a graph of ramp slope versus number of washers, remember for each additional washer, we adjust the ramp slope until we get constant velocity, and then we have a point on the graph, a ramp slope and a number of washers. The slope of this is going to be the units of ramp slope per washer. So by how much do we change the ramp slope every washer? By 0.01 units of ramp slope. Remember, a unit of ramp slope is really unitless, so we just have to talk about units of ramp slope. So does each washer cause a change of 0.01 in the ramp slope, or entail a change of 0.01 or 0.02 or 0.005? How much does each washer change the ramp slope that we need to get constant velocity? And of course, we have already observed for a ramp coasting freely, or for a cart coasting freely down a ramp, how the slope, or how we get a graph of acceleration versus ramp slope. And the slope of this graph tells us how many centimeters per second squared of acceleration change, delta acceleration, per unit of ramp slope. So if we change the ramp slope by a tenth of a unit, we should get about 98 centimeters per second squared change in acceleration. And we've observed this. Now when we put all three of these pictures together, what's our situation? Well, we've observed acceleration versus ramp slope, acceleration versus number of washers, and ramp slope versus number of washers independently. Each of these experiments depicted by the little picture is an independent experiment, an independent observation of two of the quantities, acceleration, number of washers, and ramp slope. One of our first questions is, are our results consistent? And we'll address that question shortly.